in this week's Wildlife News Brief: Shark Week controversies, a rhino evacuation plan, monkey selfie drama, and one seriously adorable elephant rescue. All this and more, this is your 2-Minute Nature News Roundup. Wildlife officials in South Africa are planning to evacuate a large number of rhinos from the eastern boundary of Kruger National Park. Nearly 640 rhinos have been poached so far this year, and most of them from this area. The emergency move will see up to 500 rhinos move to safe locations in and outside of the country. Still in South Africa, Johannesburg Zoo's last remaining polar bear has died. It's sad news, but the zoo has made the great decision not to replace the bear. Arctic animals just don't belong in the African climate. A newborn elephant that was separated from its herd in a remote part of Kenya has been rescued by the Sheldrick Wildlife Trust. After medical attention and a lot of milk, it's doing just fine. Off to the ocean and Shark Week 2014. As expected, it's been another controversial year. We've got the scoop on earthtouchnews.com, along with scientifically accurate news and articles about our favorite ocean predators. In some good shark news, fishermen in Massachusetts and New York have reported an increase in shark numbers. Researchers suspect this has something to do with cleaner water boosting fish numbers in the area. Will we see similar success down south? Kaikoura, one of New Zealand's biggest marine biodiversity hotspots, has new protections against overfishing and mineral exploration. It sounds like a win, but conservationists are skeptical about how much impact these protections will really have. Off to Europe and bearded vultures in Switzerland. In the past, these amazing birds were hunted to near extinction by farmers who saw them as a threat to livestock, but now the numbers are on the up. The same can't be said for Scotland's endangered natterjack toad, which scientists are trying to save with photography. Each toad has a unique wart and stripe pattern, which is going into a database of natterjack mugshots. The photo IDs will help scientists track the toad population. And finally, who do you think owns this selfie? The photographer, Wikipedia, or the monkey? It's a debate that's raging on the internet, and we'd love to know what you think. Also, don't forget to send us any news or story ideas you might have. We'll see you next week. Bye for now.